What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. And as you know, if you're a fan of deathcore, Lorna Shore has just dropped another EP and another music video. We're gonna be checking out And I Return to Nothingness, and I'm excited, man, to hear some more music from them and also to hear some more demonic vocals from Mr. Will Ramos. Checked out a live video of, I guess it's like a fan perspective of To the Hellfire, and man, he sounds really good live. I love that when a musician sounds just as good live as they do in the studio. That's great. That means they care about their instrument, and that means they actually care about you know, their fans too. So anyways, we're gonna jump right into this. This is And I Return to Nothingness, of course, by Lorna Shore. Epic as always. A fucking riff. I have no clue what's going on in the video. Dude just sounds like a monster. Yeah. sir. That's a sick solo. Wild. Wow, man, what a wild fucking ride. So I was trying to pay attention to the music video. I guess it seems like maybe he was uploading a virus to a something. I really don't know what the hell is going on in the video, but music videos are getting much more. The production quality is getting much higher than they ever used to be. That being said, it was a very complex song, and it was easy to be distracted by the music video. And which made me kind of lose track of the song at some points. Which, by the way, the song is a little bit longer and more drawn out than I think it needed to be. It just kind of kept going on and on. It didn't quite catch my attention like To the Hellfire did. The length of the songs are almost the same. This one was 6 minutes 13 seconds, the other one was 6 minutes 6 seconds. But for some reason, it didn't quite grab my attention like To the Hellfire did. The breakdown was nice. There was like, I think there was two of them, or it was one breakdown that came twice, but it just didn't grab my attention like the other song did. And I know they have an EP out, and there's only three songs on it, which, you know, To the Hellfire and this one are on that one. And there's another song, Of the Abyss, which I haven't heard yet, but I'm probably gonna check it out later today. I don't know if I'll do a video for it, but I'll probably check it out. So I don't know. Like, this song had everything you wanted. It has blast beats, double bass that never ends, had a guitar solo, breakdowns. It was very epic all the way through. Maybe it just needs to grow on me a little bit. Maybe I need to listen to it some more. But I liked it. You know, it's not nothing to hate on. It just didn't grab my attention like I thought it would. But overall, it's a really badass song. They have a sound, and I just like the sound. Even if like I'm not loving the song, I enjoy the sound that I'm listening to, and it's a wild ride regardless. And like I said in the beginning, Will Ramos, man, I hope I'm saying that right. I don't know if it's Ramos, Ramos, but he sounds fucking good, man. I did listen to Immortal, which had CJ McCreery. Honestly, I think CJ McCreery might be a little more of a more heavier sound, or I don't know. I don't know how to compare the two, but they're two different guys. They sound different, and I kind of prefer CJ McCreery's way of doing things, but Will does a really good fucking job too. He's a really good replacement for this band. I do remember listening to them a long time ago when like Godmaker came out, and I really don't know how old that is. I just remember the song and falling in love with it the moment I heard it. Really good song. Also, I don't know who the vocalist was back then. Maybe it was CJ McCreery. I really don't know. But anyways, I'm kind of just rambling on here. Like, they haven't had any bad vocalists, so they always sound like Lorna Shore, which is really good. They need to keep it that way and just keep doing what they're doing. The endurance it takes to play one of these songs on the drums is like, you know, top tier. It's the top difficulty that comes with the drumming. So I give that dude so much respect for even playing one of these songs, let alone like what, five or six live when they play their shows, and going on tour like that, man, it's just like you have to be sore and worn out all the time, unless you're just used to it. I don't know. I can't play a song like this just yet. I'll just stick to the easy stuff like metalcore until I get used to it. The riffs were just fucking amazing. Like, man, just I want to play guitar like that. I love death metal, melodic death metal, and that's what they were had going on pretty much, is just really fucking technical riffs and man, all sorts of shit. And the solo was amazing. It fit the song perfectly. I mean, there's nothing really to hate on. The only thing I dislike about it is it felt like a very long song, and it was just kind of dragging on in a little bit. But like I said, I'm probably just going to listen to it more and get the actual feel for it. Upon first listen, it was just a long song, and that's the only thing I have bad to say about it. Other than that, epic job, guys. Like, a fucking beautiful song. You guys always put out really good music, and you never disappoint. That's all I got to say, pretty much. So, anyways, I can't wait to hear Into the Abyss, and man, I'm excited for that one. Love these guys, man. I can't wait till they have a full album out with Will Ramos, just so I can hear that. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and don't forget to subscribe so you can check out some more. And also, don't forget to comment below if you have some suggestions so I can check some more songs out. Anyways, guys, it's been fun. I'll see you guys on the next video. Thank you so much for watching.